my entry into the profession of IT was accidental. My first university degree that I started was economics and commerce with a Japanese minor. So I changed degrees a number of times before eventually moving into IT. And how that came about is I was working as just a temporary administrator for a company back in Australia. And as the company grew, we ended up having to move into certain areas of specialty. So some people moved into finance, some people moved into HR. And I found I had a natural affinity for IT. I just never thought of IT as a profession when I was in college, hence never choosing it as a university degree. But as the years rolled past and I started working, I ended up doing an IT degree via distance education. So I now have academic qualifications as well as a lot of practical experience on the job. It's fair to say that the industry is still not equitably represented by women. So depending on who you ask, there are about 20% of the population IT professionals are female, which is obviously not where we'd like it to be. What that means on the ground means that typically you're going to have male colleagues. So whereas a lot of women find friends in the workplace, that can be a little bit more difficult because your colleagues and the people that you would otherwise be friends with are more male than female. That's not always a problem, but that is something that I have noticed. But otherwise, I don't think that a lot of the stereotypes are actually that true. I don't see that there's a glass ceiling. And certainly in recent years, there have been a lot more interest in getting women into senior positions within IT. That's something I've definitely noticed. Yeah, I think where women are going to add different values is certainly in more senior positions. The positions of leadership, where a woman's perspective is potentially quite different to a man's, just as people are different. But obviously in a leadership position, you're able to influence more change. I think at the operator level, then the difference between a man and a woman is just going to come down to personality, and there's not going to be anything quite gender specific. But certainly in positions of leadership, I can see a difference in how a man and a woman might see, tackle, and appreciate the set of circumstances. Yeah, my job title is Chief Information Officer. So I am a member of the board, I report to the CFO, who reports to the CEO, and I have regular interactions with the CEO. So in terms of what I'm responsible for, that's the entire IT function. There is no day that is like the previous day. When you get to a position of management and leadership, a lot of your day is going to be spent in meetings. There is no way around that. But what I'm responsible for is anything and everything IT. So that's email systems, that's printers, that's the information systems that enable us to deliver services to clients, it's business intelligence, it's everything in between. So most of my time is and should be spent on understanding the business strategy and how IT can deliver value against that. But there is necessarily a lot of time that's also spent in making sure that the IT function is healthy, it's performing the way it should be done, the reporting, line management, career management, etc. So my day is very, very varied, but it's because I have a very wide remit. Every business is different, so what is going to drive business A is potentially quite different to what's going to drive business B. The organisation that I work for is very much a business process outsourcer combined with knowledge process outsourcer. So where IT makes or breaks this business is our ability to harness, capture intellectual property. So it's making sure that we codify and capture what our individual people know and push that to the right person at the right time. So we've got an enormous opportunity to shape the business in terms of management information, business intelligence, collateral, knowledge sharing, social media, social networking. It really is the DNA of how a business operates. Without IT, there is no business. IT is the thing that shapes a business, and by extension, IT is the thing that can reshape a business. So the way technology changes means that businesses are always changing. IT has an enormous part to play in how we provide our services, the systems that we use, how we support a mobile workforce, how we make sure that we're able to grow globally and make sure that the person in the US harnesses the knowledge that the person in the UK has developed. That whole operation, our ability to go global, to support a workforce, to to support bringing on new clients with their individual requirements. All of that is enabled by IT. Without IT, you're back to a world of people sitting around a meeting room with notepads and pens, and that's just not the way any business operates anymore.